Wine vending machines. They're supposed to be a convenience, but some customers have found them confusing.
Yeah, and get this. Now Team 4 goes undercover, finds the Liquor Control Board has actual clerks babysitting these machines. Here's investigative reporter Paul Van Osdal. Paul.
Well, Wendy, we found clerks reading books and texting when they were working at the vending machines, which are known as kiosks, but they did not seem to have much else to do. A critic of the Liquor Control Board says our findings reveal one more reason liquor sales should be privatized. Our camera was there as this woman tried to use a wine kiosk. After swiping her driver license and credit card, she blows into a breathalyzer twice so the Liquor Control Board can make sure she's sober. There's actually an LCB employee in Harrisburg monitoring all this on video. Then she waits and waits and waits. And then she has to do another breath test. Finally, she's able to get her wine. Experiences like hers are one reason the LCB assigned employees to babysit the kiosks.
But also gives us an opportunity to get some instant feedback on how they are working now and the customer acceptance.
But we saw a few customers at the kiosks. I asked this LCB employee to show me how to use the kiosk at the Monroeville Giant Eagle. After she gives a brief explanation, our camera follows her as she goes back to reading the book we had seen her reading earlier. We found another LCB employee working on a book at a kiosk in McCandless. After we'd been watching her for a couple minutes, she decided to sit on her book. In Cranberry, this employee was spending his time texting. It's hard to blame them. They don't have much else to do.
Some of these kiosks are only selling 5 to 7 bottles a day.
We asked the head of the LCB if employees at kiosks, the agency calls them pronto machines, were allowed to read on the clock.
It is absolutely not appropriate unless it's a pronto kiosk manual.
We did see these manuals at a couple kiosks, but we did not see any employees reading them. House Majority Leader Mike Terzai is leading the effort to privatize the LCB.
It's a contradiction to have somebody there to work on the kiosk when the kiosk was supposed to save on manpower in the first place and provide some level of convenience.
Convenience was the idea, but the LCB had to shut down the kiosks in December because of mechanical problems. When they reopened last month, the LCB assigned clerks to babysit the machines and make sure there were no problems.
Well, it's not wasteful because these are store employees that were pulling away from a store close proximity.
But Terzai says, why not do this? Allow people to buy wine from grocery store clerks as they do in West Virginia.
This was their attempt at providing some alternative to a private market, but it seems to me it's failed miserably.
The head of the LCB believes the kiosks have in fact been a success, especially here in Western PA, some of them selling as many as 70 bottles a day. As of now, the LCB plans to keep those employees at the kiosks for a month. Now, Governor Corbett and the Republican-controlled legislature are still pushing forward with plans to privatize the agency. A big incentive, the $4 billion state budget deficit. Live in the newsroom, Paul Van Osdal, Channel 4 Action News.